I'm Kim Starr and I'm 47 years old. I was diagnosed with triple negative breast cancer at the end of 2012. And so I started my process with talking with oncologists and breast surgeons and everything, and I had to go through chemotherapy because I had triple negative. It was in one place, so they said I would just need a lumpectomy, but I just knew going in that I wanted to just get rid of them, just have a bilateral and, you know, be done with it. So part of my journey was to find a great plastic surgeon that I felt really good about working with. I'd interviewed some other plastic surgeons and I wasn't connecting with them on an emotional or personal level. And so I called Dr. Haddock, the phone number that they gave me for Dr. Haddock, and it was actually his cell phone number, and he answered. And so I told him right away, "I'm sorry, I'll call the office." He said, "Oh, no, 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 what can I help you with?" And so right then I knew that it was going to be a good connection because I knew he was, you know, had a good bedside manner, if you will. So I came in to meet Dr. Haddock, and I told him that I wanted to do a bilateral. And so he did my put in my expanders. He said, "Well, since you've had radiation, sometimes an implant, it doesn't always work well with a radiated breast." So he said, "You have enough tummy tissue where we can rebuild your breasts, but not fully." So he said, you've got some on the back of your legs that we could take off and make your entire breast with. So that was a no-brainer to me because I got a flat stomach and thinner thighs out of it. And now I have a better body than I had going into cancer and into cancer treatment. I was not nervous at all. I mean, I was ready to move forward with this. It was something that I felt intuitively after all my meetings with Dr. Haddock that it was going to be a really good outcome for me. With both areas being, you know, worked on, those first few hours of waking up from surgery were not fun. I mean, it was, you know, it was painful, but they were great in the hospital and they helped me with, you know, getting through it. A nurse was constantly there helping me to the restroom and helping me get out of bed. And looking back, I don't have a lot of bad memories about it. You know, I just did what Dr. Haddock asked me to do, and that was lay in bed, don't lift anything heavy, just let your body, you know, heal. I was able to lift my arms quickly after my bilateral with my expanders in. I was able to start radiation earlier because I was able to lift my arms, you know, both with the reconstruction and with the expanders. I mean, we were given exercises. Me and my husband, you know, Dr. Haddock told us to be doing some exercises, you know, like raising your arms up like that and raising your, you know, putting them down and, you know, doing this kind of thing and down just to keep things moving and keep things circulating. So that was another thing. I mean, we abided by every rule that he gave us. And I think that was, you know, another reason why we had a good success, because we took what he said seriously and we did it. So the fat grafting, what happened was on the radiated side, the side on my right side, I had a little bit of, I guess what Dr. Haddock would maybe call an indention. I didn't see it, didn't bother me, but him being the perfectionist, you know, he said, "Let's go back in and, you know, fill that in, you know, a little bit with some fat grafting." And I can't even remember where he took the fat from. You know, I think maybe some more off of my inner thighs, I think is where he did it. And he put it in here, and the recovery time was, I mean, it was amazing. I don't ever even remember being down from that. I just got up and, you know, did life. When I was diagnosed, I got on the ball. I got the ball rolling really quickly. I wanted to get everything lined up. So once I talked to my oncologist, got my breast surgeon lined up, for me personally, I needed to connect with somebody that was going to, number one, be a part of my cancer journey, because that's, you know, obviously very serious and very emotional. You know, have trust in that I felt like they were gonna take the best care of me and that they really cared, you know, not that I was just another patient. I came in and met with them, and I knew for sure then. And my husband loved him. And so he had me at hello, if you will. That's kind of dorky, I know. But then when he started telling me, you know, what he could do with my breasts, you know, because I was, let's see, 44 when I was diagnosed. So, and I was larger busted to begin with, naturally. So just with time, my, you know, breasts had started sagging some. And I couldn't go without a bra. And, you know, I was constantly having to put on a bra around the house. My baby was only 4 months old when I was diagnosed. So I still had some tummy left over. So when he told me I would have, you know, I mean, it would be a flat, it's like in a tummy tuck, you know. To me, it was just a no-brainer. His personality and what he said he could do, thinner thighs, all of that, I was like, sign me up, I'm in, let's get going. So it's been a really great experience. And he made it enjoyable for my husband too. My husband waited in the waiting room the whole entire time. He's a race car driver. They would give him updates. Like they would say, okay, if you're on lap 50 out of 300 races, that's kind of where we are, you know? So it just made it really personable and human. I think for somebody starting the journey, I don't want to get emotional. Now I'm going to get emotional. For someone starting this journey, the best advice that I can give you is fight for yourself. You know, use your intuition. Pick the doctors that connect with you, that you connect with, because it'll make it so much easier, you know. Don't let somebody else pick a doctor for you. You know, you pick your doctor. First of all, is just be true to yourself, fight for yourself, be strong, pray. It's a lot to deal with. And if your mindset's not there, you know, mind, body, soul connection. And if your mindset's not there, I don't think your body's gonna let you heal as quickly either, you know? And try to find the best out of it. Don't focus on the bad, you know, like, oh, I'm gonna be cut, and you know, and oh, I'm, you know, I gotta go to surgery. Well, look at it like, okay, I'm gonna get a better body and I get to, you know, have people look after me for a good week. Go into it with a great frame of mind too. You know, find it, like Dr. Haddock and I tease him, you know, I'm like, make me look like a supermodel, and he's like, I'm on it. You know, find the best that you can out of it is what I would say. Sorry. It is an emotional journey, that's for sure.